Today's lunchtime class, we focused a lot on technique because we had a smaller class than usual. We basically ran it almost like a private lesson, so one of the advantages of coming to our class is that you do end up with
one-to-one
or one to a small group tuition to really work in Canva. So we won't really do a full recap here, but there was lots of stuff on Folkadas, Ochos, pivots, warps. There was lots of detail in there. So this not gets covered in our normal class, but it's always good just to focus. If you have got the time or the money, if you want private lessons, then contact us. We can really help you work on technique and rebuild your Tango that way. Anyway, in the evening class, we looked at what's known as poses and musicality. So we also had a discussion about what how musical phrases work and how it relates to what's known as traditional tango music, which is fairly formulaic. So without really listening to the music, you can find the end of phrases fairly easily and it can get you stuck. However, if you expand yourself up into other forms of music, especially modern pop music or classical music, you've got variations in your phrasing and changes in your phrases, which really allow you to help express yourself, and it's a really good way of massively improving your musicality, which can't really be taught. So what we looked at is, first of all, the front ocho. So we start off with front step on the left, a step behind with the right foot, and pick a follower across and around yourself, get into the front ocho. We talked about the technique of how to form a pivot, by arching the foot around to help generate the torque. We then took this into doing some planeo. So if I drop my weight slightly, as I step to the side, the follower's foot will sweep around in a plane, which creates a nice shape. I can bring this up, and I can use this to really emphasize a build in the phrase or the end of the phrase. And if I wanted to, if it's a long phrase, I could use this to do something with a calcitonin. So I'm leaving it down there to form this shape. Obviously, don't do this on every phrase. You've got your own sense of how to interpret the music for this, so you don't always have to stick to just doing this. We then look at how to finish phrases with a bit of a pose. So if I had to turn my follower around to, we'll do this position for the camera. Yeah, if it's this position, if I just pause, she can decorate the phrases herself. So she can do, these are called castigato ballets. They can be smooth and fluid, they can be sharp and staccato. They can be circular, have circular motions in it, they can come out. There's so many variations, and they're entirely up to you what you choose to do, providing that you feel that you're interpreting music and you haven't got caught in between and you're just doing the same one all the time. We then had a look at doing sort of just other ways of emphasising the end of the phrase. So if we're just walking, we could just come to a pause, form a nice line. So we talk about the importance of doing lines. What we could also do is drop the follower down, so you've got these forms of lunge and shiver and balance. Follower can go down as far as she is comfortable with, and we can create these striking poses. Again, these are not to be overused, they're more for if you are doing a showcase or there's lots of space on the floor, because these do take up a lot of space. So you don't hang every single phrase in one of these big movements, it gets a bit over the top when you're doing that. So, a bit of an odd recap video today, because just of the content, it doesn't mean it lends itself through to a talk through. But hopefully you'll find it useful to add to your styling already, rather than replacing it, because you want to build upon that and encourage you to explore your own stuff. Anyway, that was the recap. Thank you for watching this Urban Tango Nights recap. If you like these videos, please subscribe to our channel by clicking the logo. You can find more of our class summaries down here and other videos of us dancing tango over here. You can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and Meetup. Links are in the description below. And you can also subscribe to our newsletter using the link below.